Hey, what's going on, guys? Red Rhino Music here, bringing you another video. I know I haven't done I skipped a couple days of episodes, but I've been doing some other things on the side, so please forgive me. Videos this week will be back to normal, starting with this showdown. Today we're doing something a little stupid. We're going to do the BRZ, the Subaru BRZ, versus the Toyota GT86. Now you might be wondering why, since it's the same exact car pretty much down to the fog lights are like the only difference. I just wanted to see if one has an advantage over the other, or just which one I can drive better in around our track here. Anyways, we'll start with the BRZ. The BRZ has 200 horsepower, 151 foot-pounds of torque, and it weighs 2,764 pounds. And the GT86 has 197 horsepower, so 3 whole horsepower less. Wow. 151 foot-pounds of torque, so the same. And it weighs 30 pounds less than the BRZ at 2,734 pounds. So if you have the BRZ, I would skip lunch. But, yeah, they're pretty similar. There are some minor differences. Where one has more horsepower, it also has more weight for whatever reason. I don't know what the hell's in the car that adds 30 pounds. It's probably like a sound system or something stupid. And the prices, they're pretty much the same. They're both, one's 24 and one's 25, I think. Or it's 25 and 26. It's like an $800 difference. But other than that, that's it for the specs. Let's take it around the track and see which one wins for whatever reason it wins. Here we go. They're pretty even. Not that I didn't expect that. Now these cars coming up ahead are going into the turn. The thing I've noticed with these two cars is when you brake late, the car will not like it. Like you can see the GT86 got a little sideways there. And this for this turn, I didn't even brake at all, because in my practice laps for both cars, I would just fly straight into that barricade on the right. Alright, so they're still pretty neck and neck. The BRZ is a little bit ahead because the GT86 slid out a little bit before. Let's see if we can make up that time. Still neck and neck. The BRZ is probably like one car length, if not even that, ahead. GT86 is getting a little wobbly coming out of that turn though. It's going a little loosey-goosey, so is the BRZ. Here we come to the finish. The BRZ wins it at 120.347. The GT86 gets a 120.480. Alright, the BRZ wins, which I kind of expected that. Just because I don't know. I'm biased because it's a Subaru compared to a Toyota, and I just kind of think a Toyota isn't as good as a Subaru, but I have no proof of that or any reasoning, so I don't know. But I think it all came down to the GT86 getting slightly sideways coming out of that S-turn. Now, I talked about it a little bit during the laps, and I was saying that if you brake slightly late, it will like throw the car. It'll throw like the back of the car. I was using simulated steering for that race for both cars. But I had to like get warmed up in those things to like get going, because they were just difficult to drive for whatever reason. It's probably because they're short wheelbase and it's like a kind of like a liftoff oversteer. But no matter what you would do, braking in a corner late, it would just slide into something. So I either had to not brake. For a lot of that race, I wasn't even braking. Like the, after the uphill, I wasn't braking for that turn. It's like the third to last turn, I would say. There was no braking there. Normally, that's like a pretty heavy braking zone. The second to last turn, I definitely was braking, but, yeah, I don't know. It's something weird with those cars with the braking. And I guess because they're just small cars. If I had to pick between which one I would get off of that race, I think the GT86 is actually the faster of the two. I don't really know why. They're the same car, but for whatever reason, I know that thing would have been faster if it didn't slide out for that one thing. But I did equally push each car. For whatever reason, the BRZ didn't get sideways. I don't know if the game is realistic enough for the driver's side to matter, because that could be a thing with it. Like the fact that the Subaru, you're on the left, and GT86, you're on the right. I don't know if the game, like, has physics for that, but that could be a factor. But, yeah, if I had to buy a short car, a short wheelbase kind of sports two-door budget car, I'd buy neither and I'd get a Miata.